Hello everybody, welcome to our YouTube channel number 1 doctor. Today we will talk about chest pain. Perioperative myocardial infarction may occur during the operation triggered most commonly by hypotension, in which case it is detected by the EKG monitor straight depression, T-wave flattening. When it happens post-op, it is typically within the first 2 to 3 post-op days, showing up chest pain only in 1/3 of the cases, and with the complications of the MI in the rest. The most reliable diagnostic test is troponin. Mortality 50-90 greatly exceeds that of MI not associated with surgery. Treatment is directed at the complications. Clot busters cannot be used in the perioperative setting, but emergency angioplasty and coronary stent may be used. Pulmonary embolus PE typically happens around PO day 7 in elderly and/or immobilized patients. The PINE is pleuritic, of sudden onset, and is accompanied by shortness of breath. The patient is anxious, diaphoretic, and tachycardic, with prominent distended veins in the neck and forehead. A low CVP virtually excludes the diagnosis. Arterial blood gases show hypoxemia and hypocapnia. The standard diagnostic test is a spiral CT with intravenous dye, commonly referred to as a CT angio. After confirming the diagnosis, start treatment with heparinization. Add an inferior vena cava filter greenfield if PEs recur during anticoagulation or if anticoagulation is contraindicated. Prevention of thromboembolism will in turn prevent PE. Sequential compression device can be used on anyone who does not have a lower extremity fracture. In high-risk patients, anticoagulation is indicated. Risk factors include age 40, pelvic or leg fractures, venous injury, femoral venous catheter, and anticipated prolonged immobilization.